Hello friends, this is a series on computer graphics from School of Engineering, Department of Computer Science and Engineering. The name of the course is Computer Graphics and the code is CS351, credits 302, and it is meant for 5th semester CSE students for the session July 2015 to December 2015. My name is Arun Kumar. The main objective of this course is this course is designed to discuss the principles and methods of computer graphics and its applications in solving problems requiring visualization of complex objects of real world. The suggested textbook for this course is Computer Graphics C version in English, second edition by Pearson India, and the author is Donald D. Hahn and Pauline Baker. The next slide shows the photograph of the front page of the book which you can buy. This is purely based upon the programming in C concepts. Now this present video show will try to cover as much syllabus as possible for syllabus for midterm 1. The midterm 1 syllabus that we have included here is number 1, Introduction to Computer Graphics. It includes Survey of Computer Graphics, Overview of Computer Graphics Systems. Number 2, Display Devices, CRT Basics, Raster Scan and Random Scan Displays Units, Flat Panel Displays. Number 3, Input-Output Devices, Keyboards, Mouse, Trackballs, Spaceballs, Joysticks, Data Globe, Digitizers, Image Scanner, Touch panels, light pens, voice systems, hard copy devices, plotters, inkjet plotters, dye sublimation printers, pen and ink plotters, laser printers. In the fourth, logical interactive devices, locator function, the valuator function, the choice function. Number 5, we shall start with the line drawing algorithms, in which we have included two algorithms. Number 1, DDA. Number 2, Bresnahan line drawing algorithm. This video, that is present CG video lecture 1, shall include 3 units. We shall cover the basic portions of midterm 1 and the CG lecture video 2 includes lecture series 4 and 5, and they will complete the whole midterm syllabus to be conducted in the month of August. Now let us start the course. The first thing, what is computer graphics? The term computer graphics was coined in 1960 by William Fretter to describe new design methods while he was pursuing his research career at Boeing. Fretter designed with the help of reproduced images on a pen plotter exploring cockpit design using a 3D model of a human body. The diagram is as shown here. The interactive computer graphics is the most important thing that takes things. Interactive computer graphics involves input, processing and display units as shown in the diagram. The input unit is composed of mouse, tablet and stylus, free force feedback devices, scanners, live video streams. Display units include screen, paper-based printers, video recorders, projectors, and audio recording systems. Any interactive system is purely based upon these three major components. The computer graphics is the technology of presenting information in a beautiful way. The branch of computer science, which mainly deals with formation, manipulation, storage, and display of the image, adding additional information and graphical effects such as shading, tilting, filling of colors, morphing, etc. The benefits of computer graphics, the first important benefit is that it finds application in movies both at Bollywood and Hollywood. You can see the first and the second diagram picture which are taken from the movie shots, and they are purely based upon computer graphics and there is nothing original about them. Now you see here the second one is the games, and CG computer graphics is greatly involved in the concept of playing games, that is the digital games on the being played on the computers. The basic focus is on interactivity between the different users and to provide a cost-effective solution, avoiding computation and other tricks. Games drive the baseline. Now, you see, everyone is playing games, and this computer graphics providing 3D and 4D, 5D, and all these combinations provide a better game facilities for the individuals and keep them glued to the screen. Now, there is another concept of computer graphics which is involved in medical imaging. Medical imaging is purely involves the data representation and modalities, drive issues of precision and correctness, focuses on presentation and interpretation of data, construction of models from acquired data. The fourth major most important benefit of computer graphics is computer-aided design. Computer graphics had a dramatic impact on the design process. Today, most mechanical and electronic designs are executed entirely on computer, increasingly architectural and product designs. This involves use of computer-aided designing softwares, which are purely based upon the concept of computer graphics. Computer-aided design follows the implementation, actually the design of the hardware gadgets. It involves the integration of computing and display sources, reduced design cycles. And the fifth benefit of computer graphics is scientific visualization. Now, the term scientific visualization involves the use of computer graphics in the scientific experiments, which involves display of information like display of molecular structure, like as shown in the diagram here. It also involves the use of, in the sixth benefit, it is the graphical creation of graphical user interface. With the help of computer graphics, we are able to generate GUI-based systems which are used for installing softwares on the computers and which have made life quite easier. And the installation of operating systems, installation of other softwares has become very easy. In just clicks, we can load the operating systems, as shown in the diagrams here. You will find that the GUIs are presented here, and we can reach at any component with just a click. Now, the basic functions of computer graphics are creation of objects by taking data from input, taking data input from coordinates like freehand drawing, specific input from keyboard and scan. Secondly, manipulation such as correction, modifications and changing shape, size, color, etc. Production, mainly printing and plotting. The characteristics of computer graphics are: number one, interactive nature and preview capability of computer processing systems. Number two, CG provides joy and adventure in the form of cartoon movies and video games. Number three, high resolution displays. Number four, to run packages it requires a proper training. And number five, the final picture displayed is the net result of creativity inside the human beings. Number six, computer graphics plays a vital role in building, design and construction, electronic design, mechanical design, entertainment and animation, aerospace industry, medical technology, cartography, arts and commerce. Now let us talk about a few of the display technologies. That is, we want to get the information to be displayed on the monitors. Now, what kind of monitors were earlier present and how the changes have taken place? Let us have a glance over them. The first thing that we are going to see today is the cathode ray tubes. It's the most important device that is present day available, but you will find that CRTs have been modified in their design altogether. Now, this present diagram shows display of a CRT with evacuated glass bottle. Heating element is also shown here, and you can see that there is an electron beam which is striking here. The vertical and the horizontal deflection plates are also visible. The beam strikes the phosphor coating on the front of the tube. Now, this is the original internal diagram which represents the overall working of a CRT. In this diagram, we are able to see a heating coil which is represented as a heater, on the extreme neck of the CRT, you will find another control grid. When the heating coil is heated, it generates electrons, and those electrons strike the phosphor screen, thereby generating heat and light, and the electrons are produced, and the energy is released. Now, the cathode ray, the electron beam is passed through the deflecting coils. As shown here in the diagram, you will be able to see that there are two deflecting coils here, and these deflecting coils, they deflect the electron beam, and it strikes at a particular position on the fluorescent screen, which is made up of phosphorus. There are two focusing coils are also available here, which will focus the beam of the electron gun onto the phosphorus screen. The CRT or the video monitors are the most common output devices on the computers today. A CRT is an evacuated glass bottle with a heating element on one end and a phosphorus coated screen on the other. When a current flows through the heating element called filament, the conductivity of the metal filament is reduced due to high temperature. A beam of electrons or cathode rays emitted by an electron gun passes through the focusing and the deflection system that directs the beam towards specified position on the phosphorus coated screen. The phosphor then emits a small spot of light at each position contacted by the electron beams, but this light fades very rapidly. Therefore, to maintain the picture on the screen or to keep the phosphor glowing, we can redraw the picture rapidly by directing the electron beam back over the same points again. The type of display that we have presently seen is called as a refresh CRT. The electron gun in CRT consists of number 1, the heated metal cathode, number 2, the control grid. The intensity of the electron beam is controlled by setting the voltage on the control grid, which is a metal cylinder that fits over the cathode. The CRT is refreshed to avoid flicker at least 60 Hz. But exact number depends upon the image intensity, ambient lighting, and wavelength size of the screen. The intensity level of individual screen positions can be specified with graphic software commands. The focusing system in a CRT is needed to focus the electron beam to converge into a small spot. It strikes the phosphor, otherwise the electron will repel each other and the beam would spread out as it approaches the screen. Focusing is accomplished with either electric or magnetic fields. Electrostatic focusing is commonly used in television and computer graphics monitors. Additional focusing hardware is used in high precision systems to keep the beam in focus at all screen positions. Now let us see one of a few of the terms which are used in display technology. The very first term is persistence. There are different kinds of phosphors available for use in CRT. Besides a color major difference between phosphors is their persistence. The term persistence is defined as how long the electrons continue to emit light after the CRT has been removed. We can further define persistence as the time it takes the emitted light from the screen to decay to 1/10 of its original intensity. Lower persistence phosphorus requires higher refresh rates. The graphics monitors are constructed with persistence range of 10 to 60 microseconds. The second most important definition, that is resolution. The maximum number of points that can be displayed without overlap on a CRT is referred to as resolution. The resolution of CRT is dependent on the type of phosphor, the intensity to be displayed, and the focusing and the deflection system. The typical resolution of a high quality system is 1280 x 1024. The high resolution systems are often referred to as high definition systems. The resolution is measured in terms of number of scan lines, the number of pixels per scan lines, and the number of bits per pixel. The third most important definition is aspect ratio. The ratio of the vertical points to the horizontal points necessary to produce equal length lines in both the directions on the screen is called as aspect ratio. The aspect ratio is 3 by 4. It means the vertical line with 3 points is equal to the length to the horizontal line of 4 points. Let us have a final look at the CRT that is available here. The diagram shows here the cathode, the accelerating anodes, diffraction coil, the beam, the phosphorus screen. Now we have divided the display systems into two major categories. One is called as raster scan, another one is called as random scan. The raster scan systems are purely graph based systems, and random scan are command based systems that we will be now realizing them. You will see that the calligraphic or the random scan display systems. Phosphorus fluorescence is the light emitted as electrons unstable, electrons are unstable, they lose their excess energy while the phosphorus is being struck by the electrons. Phosphorescence is the light given off by the return of relatively more stable excited electrons to their unexcited state once the electron beam excitation is removed. Phosphorus persistence is defined as the time from the removal of excitation to the moment when phosphorus has decayed to 10% of its original initial light output, that is the decay exponential. Long persistence, several seconds, short persistence, 10 to 60 microseconds, and we'll see this diagram here, the random scan displays. You can see that we can draw the sets of lines from anywhere to anywhere. Now this particular diagram shows that refresh raster scan display systems looks like a graph as shown here. Used in the television screens, unlike DBST, random scans were line drawing devices. Refresh CRTs is a point plotting devices. Raster displays store the display primitives, lines, characters, shaded patterned areas in a refresh buffer. The refresh buffer is also called frame buffer. It stores the drawing primitives in terms of points and pixel components. The raster diagram as shown here, we can see that only the pixels for representing B, those only the required pixels are illuminated, rest of the pixels will remain dark or they will not glow. Another diagram that we see here, it shows the formation of images on the raster scan systems. Here we can see that the scanning starts from extreme left corner and it goes down to the extreme right corner, then goes down by one step and one step further till it reaches the extreme right corner of the screen. When it reaches the extreme right corner of the screen, immediately it jumps back to the main first position and start scanning from there. We can see that the display of the character A and triangle formation here. Now this diagram shows the movement of the scanner, scanning lines from the extreme left side to the extreme right bottom side and then returning back to the main position. The random scan systems. Now we are going to discuss random scan systems. This is the second variety in the systems, in the display systems, and they are vectors or the strokes or the lines drawing displays. The characters are also made of sequence of strokes or short lines. They are vectored, that is the electron beam is deflected from one end point to the other end point. Random scan order of deflection is directed by the arbitrary order of display commands. Phosphor has persistence decays in 10 to 100 microseconds. The displays must be refreshed at regular intervals, minimum of 30 Hz, flicker-free display. The refresh buffer memory space allocated to store the display list or display program for the display processor to draw the picture. The display processor interprets the commands in the refresh buffer for plotting. The display processor must cycle through the display list of refresh the first mode. The display diagram has commands for point, line, character, plotting, etc. Now this diagram shows here that the images that will be made can be made directly at random from any position to any position. In the final diagram B, we are able to see that triangle has been formed and by joining three lines here in a random scan display. Now let us go through the major differences between raster scan systems and random scan systems. In a raster scan display, we see pixel by pixel. Random scan displays line by line. Picture definition is stored in memory areas called refresh or frame buffers. Picture information is stored as a set of line drawing commands in memory area called refresh display or display program. Now this display program contains commands with respect to the graphic primitives. For example, in Turbozy environment, we have a point. Point can be represented as put pixel x1, y1, x2, y2. Similarly, we can display the line as x1, y1, x2, y2. In the case of a rectangle, we will be able to see that the top left pixel or the coordinate position should be available and the bottom right coordinate position should be available in the program. So we can draw those pictures directly with the help of commands. In the raster scan display, the whole screen is refreshed. But in the case of random scan, only the area where the picture is drawn is refreshed. In the case of raster scan, memory we require more memory per time, but it requires less memory per time. And there is low resolution in the case of raster scans. In the case of random scan, there is a high resolution. There is a zigzag formation of picture as shown here in the diagram. You will see that we are not able to draw perpendicular lines. As shown, there is a smooth picture at the bottom. You will be able to see that there is a perfect line joining another line. Now let us go through the present day systems, which are the color monitors. There are two kinds of color formation systems in the CRTs. It all depends upon the kind of phosphorus and the methodology adopted to generate the colors. Now there are two basic methods for producing color displays are number one, beam penetration method, number two, shadow mask method. In the beam penetration method, random scan monitors use the beam penetration method for display of color pictures. In this, the inside of CRT screen is coated with two layers of phosphors, namely red and green. A beam of slow electrons excites only the outer red layer, while the beam of fast electrons penetrates red layer and excites the inner green layer. The intermediate beam speeds, combination of red and green light are emitted to show two additional colors, orange and yellow. So therefore, in the case of beam penetration methods, the major advantage is that they are less expensive, and the disadvantage is that we are able to generate only four colors. Now what are the colors? Red, green, orange and yellow. These are the four colors that we will be able to generate from beam penetration method. The quality of images are not good as compared to the other methods. Now let us go through the second method. This is called the shadow mask method. In this shadow mask method, raster scan systems use shadow mask methods to produce a much more range of colors. Now the range of colors has increased. The beam because it is much better than the beam penetration method. In this, CRT has three phosphor color dots. And you will find that there are three electron guns with three different color dots, which the beam is passed through a shadow mask. That is why the name is shadow mask method. Now on the screen, we are able to see three different dots of colors as the beam passes through a mask. Now this is the phosphorus dot pattern that is available here and which is used for generating the colors. Now this diagram shows that there are three electron guns R, G, B, and the inline arrangement of guns is also shown here. The three electron guns have three different color dots which pass through three the single slot and selection shadow mask, and we are able to see three different colors. Magnified phosphorus dot triangle is there. The pixels formed will also be in a triangular shape, that is also shown here. The major advantages of this system are they produce realistic images, also produce different colors, and they show shadow scenes. The major disadvantage is low resolution, expensive electron beam directed to the whole of the screen. Now for full color schemes we require 13, in our present day systems we have 34 bits of storage per pixel is required for full color systems. Now altogether the system has been advanced, we need more amount of memory for representation of more number of colors. Now this the DVSD or the digital view storage tube is the second in the category of display technologies. This DVSD, as the name stands, it stands for digital view storage tube. It is an alternative method of maintaining, it has got an alternative method of maintaining an image. There are two electron guns here. Since there are two electron guns here, which makes it much more costlier as compared to the ordinary CRT. Primary gun forms the picture pattern. The flood gun, which maintains the picture display onto the phosphorus screen. Now in this particular diagram, we are able to show the phosphorus coated screen, the collector, the storage grid, the ground level, the electron beam, the primary gun, the connector pins, the focusing system. The advantage here is that it can let the picture display for a long period of time. Refreshing is not required. Very complex pictures can be displayed at very high resolution without flicker. It is good for static pictures only, and it has got a flat screen. The major disadvantage that we will be able to see is not suitable for dynamic images. It doesn't display colors. To make a small change in picture, there is a need to redraw the entire picture again. Now there is another category of display units that is called as flat panel displays. It refers to the class of video devices that have reduced volume, weight and power requirements as compared to the CRT. The diagram shows here the flat screen. As the name suggests, it is totally flat and it is not curved in nature. There are two types of flat screens. Number one, the screens which have emissive displays. The second one is non-emissive displays. In the case emissive displays, we have plasma panels, thin film electroluminescent displays and LEDs. In the case of non-emissive displays, we have LCDs. So let us have a look at the plasma panels which fall into the category of emissive displays. It consists of two plates as shown in the diagram here, and it is constructed by a region between two glass plates with a mixture of gases, neon, xenon or helium. These gases are called as rare earth elements, and they are not utilized in the CRTs, advanced level of CRTs or the present day monitors. The material is sensitive to light, and the frame buffer, refresh buffer, stores the pixel value. Now this diagram shows that we have horizontal conductors of the electrodes, and we have a glass plate here, the glass panel, and the cells are attached to it, the vertical conductors, electrodes and the glass plate. The major advantage of this system is refreshing is not required. It produces a very steady image, totally free of flicker, less bulky than CRT. It is available in black and white as well as color displays, light weight, it can be hanged on the wall, hanged on a wall, wear them on a wrist. Selected parts of the image can be erased or updated. The major disadvantages are refresh rate is only 60 bits per second and is not suitable for animation systems. They are very slow devices and they are much more costlier than the ordinary CRTs. It requires complex addressing and wiring arrangements. Now the next category is the LCD monitors. The LCD monitors, they are the liquid crystal displays, a display technology that uses rod-shaped molecules or the liquid crystals that flow like liquid and bend light. When an unenergized form, the crystals direct light through two polarizing filters, allowing a natural background color to show. When energized, they redirect the light to be absorbed in one of the polarizers, causing the dark appearance of crossed polarizers to show. The more the molecules are twisted, the better the contrast and viewing angle. Because it takes less power to move molecules than to energize a light-emitting device, LCDs replace the light-emitting diodes in a digital watch, and it has been used since 1970s. Now this is the diagram of LCDs. This is the liquid crystal display on state and off state. And it shows transparent conductor, pneumatic liquid cells are there, and we have a polarizer. The beam is passed here, transparent conductor is shown here in the on state and also in the off state. Now the glass plates, now second diagram also shows the movement of like glass plates and light, vertical filter is there, horizontal filter, crystal molecules, all this are there. Now the next category of display units is plasma panels. The plasma panel is composed of two sheets of glass with a series of ribs like corrugated cardboard filled with color phosphors in between. The top glass with embedded electrode seals and forms a pixel where the junctions of the channels and the plate comes together. Inside the sealed pixel is a mixture of rare gases, typically argon, neon or xenon. Now these rare earth gases are used here. Now this particular diagram shows the such type of display plasma panel units. Now let us take up the topics of hardware copy devices, because they are also part of the computer graphics. We want to get the output as we are able to see on the monitors. So let us see what are the hard copy devices available with us. We have monitors, printers, plotters, and there are varieties of printers available here. The first such category is dot matrix printers, inkjet printers, drum printers, laser printers. Now let us start one by one. Let us see the dot matrix printer. The dot matrix printer or the inkjet printer is a type of computer printer with a print head that runs back and forth or in an up and down motion on the page and prints by impact, striking an ink-soaked cloth ribbon against the paper, much like a typewriter. Unlike a typewriter or a daisy wheel printer, the letters are drawn out of a dot matrix and thus varied fonts and arbitrary graphics can be produced. Because the printing involves mechanical pressure, these printers can create carbon copies and carbonless copies as well. Each dot is produced by a tiny metal rod, is called as a wire or a pin, which is driven forward by the power of tiny electromagnet or solenoid, either directly or through small levers. Facing the ribbon and the paper is a small guide plate, often made of artificial jewels such as sapphire or ruby, pierced with holes to serve as guide for prints. The moving portion of the printer is called print head, and when running the printer as a generic text device, generally prints one line of text at a time. This present dot matrix printers are dependently based on the typewriter writing system that we had earlier. Now this is the diagram of such a dot matrix printer here, and in the next we are able to see the kind of characters and the character set that is available which can be displayed, which can be printed with the help of dot matrix printers. Now let us take the another category of printers, which is called as inkjet printers. The inkjet printers form characters and images by spraying small dots of ink on the paper. They are most common type of computer printers for the general user due to their low cost, high quality of output, capability of printing in different colors and ease of use. If you ever look at a piece of paper that has come out of an inkjet printer, you know that the dots are extremely small, so small that they are tinier than the diameter of human hair, 70 microns. The dots are positioned very precisely with resolutions of up to 1440 into 720 dots per inch. The dots can have different colors combined together to create photo quality images. The next slide shows the diagram of an inkjet printer. Now let us go through the laser printers. It is another variety of printers, type of printer that utilizes a laser beam to produce an image on a drum. The light of the laser alters the electric charge on the drum wherever it hits. The drum is then rolled through a reservoir of toner, which is picked up by the charged portions of the drum. Finally, the toner is transformed to the paper through a combination of heat and pressure. This is also the way of copy machines work. Because an entire page is transmitted to a drum, before the toner is applied, laser printers are sometimes called as page printers. One of the chief characteristics of laser printer is the resolution. Resolution here means how many dots per inch they lay down. The available resolution range comes around about 300 dpi at the low end and 1200 dpi at a very high end. By comparison, offset printing usually prints 1200 to 2400 dpi. The some of the laser printers have higher resolutions with special techniques known generally as resolution enhancement. Now this is the diagram, picture shows one such type of laser printer. Now we have another variety which is called as plotters. A plotter is a type of printer that interprets the commands from a computer to make the line drawings on a paper with one or more automated pens. Unlike regular printer, the plotter can draw continuous point-to-point lines directly from vector graphics, files or commands. There are a number of different types of plotters. A drum plotter draws on a paper wrapped around a drum, which turns to produce one direction of the plot, while the pen moves to provide the other direction. A flat plot plotter draws on a paper placed on a flat surface, and an electrostatic plotter draws on negatively charged paper with positively charged toner. They are frequently used in computer-aided engineering applications such as CAD, computer-aided designs, computer-aided manufacturing. The plotter consists of an arm that moves across the paper on which the diagram or the graph needs to be drawn. A pen moves along the arm and the arm itself moves relatively to the paper. A combination of the two thus provides movement along the horizontal and the vertical axis. We have another variety of plotters which is called as drum plotters, since we want to produce large images like the movie posters. Now this is the printer which is utilized for plotting the large movie printers. Now let us see how. In this plotter, the pen moves in the horizontal direction and the drum rolls in the other axis. Generally, it is a graphical output device and is generally used to plot drawings. Width of the plot is limited by the length of the drum. The larger the drum, the larger the picture available. It is the first graphical output device produced to print large scale engineering drawings. Colored prints can be made if you use colored ink. The electronic equipment used to plot large size drawings on a tracing sheet. Plans for building, architectural drawing, engineering drawing, dress models, etc. etc. drawn using suitable packages. These drawings are plotted on a tracing sheet which can be used to produce large number of blueprints. It is very good line drawing, but it is very slow because, and also the large amount of ink is involved. Here is a pen is there which is hold and which moves in an axis, and the paper moves on y axis. Now this is the diagram of such printer which is showing the large page that is being coming out of the drawing. Now the next variety of printer is flat bed plotters. This flat bed plotter, where the paper is fixed on a flat surface and pins are moved to draw the image. This plotter can use several different color pens to draw with. The size of the plot is limited only by the size of the plotter's bed. Now you see this particular diagram here. We see here the page is there and the head is moving and it is creating an image. Now the next variety of devices we have is the input devices. There are large number of input devices that are available here for working with computer graphics. Keyboard, mouse, digitizers, trackball, touch screens, light pens, microphones, barcode readers, joysticks, scanners, voice systems. The keyboard here, that is the first input device, and the keyboard is the most common input device for entering numeric and alphabetic data into the computer system by pressing a set of keys which are mounted on the keyboard which is connected to computer system. The keys on the computer boards, keyboards are often classified as follows: alphanumeric keys, the letters and the numbers, punctuation keys, comma, period, semicolon, and so on. Special keys, function keys, control keys, arrow keys, caps, cap locks, keys, and so on. Now there is another variety which is very handy, and the name is to one of the mouse, one of the very important devices which have been used in computer graphics for improving the speed of generation of graphics images, and it is the mouse, with the help of which we can draw large number of pictures by just moving the mouse on a flat pad. The mouse is a small device that a computer user pushes across a desk surface in order to point to a place on a display screen and to select one or more actions to take from that position. A mouse consists of metal or plastic housing or casing, a ball that sticks out of the bottom of the casing and rolled on a flat surface, one or more buttons on the top of the casing, and a cable that connects the mouse to the computer. Nowadays there are two varieties of mouse available. One is called as the wired and the wireless. Now the more present day systems have wireless type of arrangement in which the mouse is free, it is not attached to the system, but through the wireless media it is connecting and making its actions feasible to the user. As the ball is moved over the surface in any direction, the sensor sends impulse to the computer that causes a mouse responsive program to reposition a visible indicator called a cursor on the display screen. The position is relative to some variable starting place. Viewing the cursor's present position, the user readjusts positions by moving the mouse. The most conventional kind of mouse has two buttons on the top. The left one is the most used, the most frequently used. Now this is the diagram of a mouse. Now we have, now suppose we want to get the digitization process. Now we need to have another kind of device that is called as a digitizer. It is a graphics tablet, digitizing tablet or a graphics pad. It is a computer device that allows one to hand draw images and graphics similar to the way one draws images with a pencil and a paper. So we can do the kind of drawing that we are able to do with the help manually. The tablet may also be used to capture data or hand-written signatures. A graphic tablet, also used as a pen pad digitizer, consists of flat surface upon which the user may draw an image using an attached stylus pen drawing apparatus. The image generally does not appear on the tablet itself, but rather is displayed on the computer monitor. Some tablets, however, come as a function secondary computer screen that you can interact with directly using a stylus. Some of the tablets are intended as general replacement for mouse as the primary pointing and navigation device for desktop computers. Now this is the image of a digital. Now the most important device which is attached to the computers is nowadays the pen. It is also called light pen. A light pen is a plotting device shaped like a pen, is connected to the video. The tip of the light pen contains a light sensitive element which when placed against the screen detects the light from the screen, enabling the computer to identify the location of the pen on the screen. Light pens have an advantage of drawing directly onto the screen, but this can become uncomfortable and they are not accurate digitizing the tablets. Now this is the diagram here. Now the most present important device nowadays is the touch screen panels which are used in making kiosks or the information kiosks as are available on airports, ATM machines, etc. This touch screen is a display which can detect the presence and the location of a touch within the display area. The term generally refers to touch or contact the display of the device by a finger or a hand. The ability to interact directly with display typically indicates the presence of a touch screen. The touch screen has two main attributes. First, it enables one to interact with what is displayed directly on the screen where it is displayed rather than indirectly with a mouse or a touchpad. Secondly, it lets one to do without requiring any intermediate device, again such as a stylus that needs to be handheld. Now with the help of our fingers we will be able to withdraw money from the ATM machines, and we can see here in the next diagram the touch screen is being operated through fingers. Now there is another variety of input devices which is called as image scanners. Image scanner is a device that optically scans images, printed text, handwriting or an object and covers it to the digital image. Common examples found in offices are variations of the desktop or flatbed scanners where the document is placed on a glass window for scanning. Handheld scanners where the device is moved by hand have evolved from next scanning vents to 3D scanners used for industrial design, reverse engineering, test and measurement, orthodontics, gaming and other applications. Mechanically driven scanners that move the document are typically used for large format documents where the flatbed design would be impractical. Modern scanners typically use a charge coupled device or a contact image sensor, CIS, as the image sensor. Now this particular image shows that of a scanner. This most important variety present days available is called the voice system. Now it is used as input device. Voice input device is a device in which the speech is used to input the data or system commands directly into the system. Such equipment involve the use of speech recognition processes and can replace or supplement other input devices. Such devices can recognize spoken words from predefined vocabulary. Some have to be trained for a particular speaker. The speech recognition, also known as automatic speech recognition or computer speech recognition, which converts spoken words to machine-readable input, for example, to a key presses, using the binary code for string of character codes. The voice recognition system is wrongly used with reference to speech recognition when actually referring to speaker recognition, on the other hand, the speech recognition tries to identify what is being said. The most important device as far as games are concerned is joystick. A joystick is an input device consisting of a stick that pivots on a base and reports its angle or direction to the device it is controlling. The joysticks are often used to control video games and usually have one or more push buttons whose state can also be read by the computer. A popular variation of the joystick used on modern video game consoles is the analog stick. The joystick has been the principal flight control of the cockpit of many aircrafts, particularly military fast jets, where the center stick or the side stick location may be employed. Joysticks are also used for controlling machines such as cranes, trucks, underwater unmanned vehicles, and zero tuning radius lawn movers. Miniature finger operated joysticks have been adopted as an input device for small electronic equipment such as mobile phones. Now, this is such an image which shows a joystick. We have another device which is called as a trackball, the last device, and it is the most important device for tracking. It is called as a trackball. It is a pointing device consisting of a ball held by the socket containing sensors to detect the rotation of the ball all about two axes, like upside down mouse with an exposed protruding ball. The user rolls the balls with the thumb fingers or the palm of the hand to move the cursor. Large tracker balls are commonly used in CAD workstations for easy precision. Now let us go through the photo gallery, which shows the how the computer graphics has been used in various areas. This figure shows the films. And now we'll see here so many films are there which are purely based upon computer graphics. We'll find Spider-Man, and we see certain elephants, and all the cartoon creatures are there which are made through computer graphics. Now in the games also we are able to see that they are purely based upon the concept of computer graphics. The virtual reality aspects, we are able to see that virtual reality concept is being applied here with the help of devices, and it is available. The computer aided design, we are able to see the computer aided design, the images and the graphs through the computer aided design softwares. We are seeing a building which is purely made with the help of computer graphics. Now this is the scientific visualization. We see here the design of a car, and we see the display of various experiments with the scientific visualizations. Now this is all for your computer graphics first lecture. This actually is an introductory lecture, and it includes the use of computer graphics, the use of computer devices. We have, in this particular lecture, we have studied the computer devices which are hard display devices. We have studied the input devices, and also we have studied the present day output devices. And in the next portion, in the next video lecture, we shall be looking into the basic programs and of formation, basic programs and algorithms for the formation of lines and points on the screen. So till then, goodbye, enjoy.